Okay, in a previous video we talked about basic theory and normal component required for making a measurement of laser beam divergence. So according to the theory, the things are happening like this. We are having a laser beam, and as it is traveling in a space, due to the diffraction event with the environment or with the medium, it is spreading, and the spread can be considered as a divergence. The theta will be given like this. Theta is the angle between the two, we can say, perimeter or border of the beam. And in that case, we need to measure the diameter of the cross section at three different places. We consider or we label them as Z, Z plus D and Z plus 2D. So in a previous video, we talked about it. It's a 30 centimeter here. Z is equal to 30, Z plus D. Again, we are making it 30 addition into that. That means 60 centimeter, and here it is 90 centimeter. So you can remember this parameter. Now what we are doing is we are taking a cross section at three different places. At 30 centimeter, we are putting a screen, and we are taking cross section. At 60 centimeter, we are putting a screen, and we are taking a cross section. And 90 centimeter, we are doing the same. From this cross section, that means spot, we need to derive certain parameter, and that parameter is diameter. So how to find out that diameter? We already said that we can find out area of any cross section with the help of graph paper. So let's consider I am having a graph paper here, and I am getting a spot. This is a magnified view, so I am getting a spot like this. Okay, it may be may not be the exactly to matching with the circle, but it is approximately look like a circle. So we consider that it is appearing like a circle. Now from this we need to find out area of this particular spot. And for that, we have prepared one table that is available in your synopsis, the circulated with you. So in this table, we need to fill up certain data. One is distance. Distance, as we already talked about here, Z, Z plus D, Z plus 2D. So you can write it, let's say, very fast is, I am taking an observation, let's say it's a 10 centimeter. So I have taken very first observation at 10 centimeter. So this is my spot at 10 centimeter. Now I want to find out area of this. So for that purpose, we need to count the blocks available in this particular circle or enclosed by this figure. So for that purpose, we are taking care of certain numbers. Let's say first one is how many complete squares they are there. So complete square, that means there is no portion which is going out of the border. Okay, the whole thing is residing inside the particular closed figure. So that's a complete square. So I'll count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Likewise, we'll do that. And let's say I got 15. Then I need to count another, we can say a square, a part of a square. That is 1 half. So I can consider a complete one. That is 1. 1 complete square. 1 half square. 1 half square, that means if I consider this one, this is 1 square. And you can consider the curve is cutting almost at half, close to half. So I count them in 1 half. So this half, again I can consider which is not complete and more than half, that is again half. So 1, 2, 3, 4, likewise I'll count, and let's say I got 8 half square. And then those who are smaller than half, so you can consider this one, this square. And if I consider a diagonal of this, this will be something like appearing like this. But curvature is cutting the portion or the portion which is within the figure that is smaller than the half. So I will consider this as a 1/3 of a square. 1/3 of a square. So I will get certain segments which are smaller than half. And those smaller than half, they will be considered as a 1/3 of a square. So let's say I got a 9 number like this. So I got 15 complete square. 18 half square. Half square, that means those who are half of a square or more than half but not complete. And 9 number, they are 1/3 of a square. 1/3 of a square, that means those who are smaller than the half of a square. So I got 9 number. We can go for 1/4, 1/5, but then the contribution from there, that will be very negligible, and that's why we neglect it. We don't want to increase the mathematics on that, and that's why we restrict up to 1/3 only. So we got 3 such kind of numbers. Now I need to find out area. For that, we can use this figure. Because I know that what is the area of this square. As we are taking a normal graph paper, this particular represents within a 1 centimeter we are getting a 10 small lines. Okay, if you see that 1 centimeter is divided into 10 millimeters. So this is one is the 1 millimeter square. One square is 1 mm square. So if I find out the area from this 15, so it is 15 mm square. I do it for this, so it's a 8. It's a half square, so I need to multiply by half. So it's a 4 mm square. And here 9 into 1 by 3, so it's a 3 mm square. So I got a total area that is 15 plus 4 plus 3. Okay, that's a 22 mm square. Now this is in mm square, you can keep it in mm square or you can convert into centimeter square also. Why we need to convert into centimeter square? Because later on we are going to find we are going to use data from this result and our parameter here, that's a distance. So this distance is we are measuring in centimeter, so this should be also in centimeter. So you convert either here or you can find out the radius from this. How can we find out the radius? We assume that the shape of a spot that is perfect circle and that's a pi r square, that will be the area. So I can find out r from there and I can find out d from that particular value and I'll get certain value in centimeter if you have converted into centimeter. Now I got a d and we label them in this manner. Okay, rather than calling them d, we will call them s1. S1 is for z distance, s1 is the diameter of the spot for z distance, s2 is the diameter of a spot for z plus d distance, and for z plus 2d distance I am going to have third circle and it will have a s3 diameter. Okay, now I am having a set of diameters for three different positions, I am having a distance value and I can use that for this particular formula. This formula represents 10 theta equation. Okay, the derivation is already given in your synopsis. You go through that and try to learn. It's a very simple geometry and certain we can say approximation. From that we are getting this formula. So this formula suggests that 10 theta is equal to 10 theta is a we can say 10 of a divergence. So 10 theta is equal to under root s1 square plus s3 square minus 2h2 square. The whole thing it will be calculated and then divided by 2. And the result will be kept under the root. Okay, you need to take care of this thing. One is S1 and S3, they are added, and S2 that is used for subtraction. After completion of this bracket, you need to divide it by 2 and then you need to take a root of that. Once you get all this value, it will be divided by the d value, and d value is actually here. We talked about it in distance. So that d value is a common addition between the two different measurement carried out. So d value will be kept here. And from that we can calculate 10 theta. And whatever result you will get it. Okay. Because according to the theory, the divergence is very less. Divergence is very less. So theta should approach to 0. Theta should approach to 0. And that's why you can consider whatever 10 theta you are getting, that will be approximately theta. Okay. According to the mathematics, you can do that. Or you can find out the theta also by doing 10 inverse. But if you do it both, you will get a theta value. And if you convert into radian, you will get it, the result is very small. Very small, that means it will not come in a radian, it will come around in a milliradian. So milliradian, that means if you convert into a parameter, here we are taking around, let's say it's a, as we gave you the 30-30 centimeter separation, the largest value is 90 centimeter. We consider as 1 meter. So at 1 meter distance, if I am getting a milliradian, so if I want to make it radian, that means I need to go for 1 kilometer. Because I need to multiply 1 meter by 1000. So if I go, or if I keep the last screen at 1 kilometer far, it will have a divergence of 1 radian. And 1 radian is a very small magnitude or component in a total measurement of angle. So it's a very negligible, and from that we can identify or we can calculate the divergence of laser beam, which is very small compared to ordinary light. So this is all about the experiment. And now you need to calculate based on the figures will be provided to you. These are the observations taken by us for different three positions, and that they will be labeled by S1, S2, S3. Spot 1, spot 2, spot 3. But then you need to find out a diameter and you need to do this calculation. Okay.